Will be interesting to see. You know, the course is played out to be favored on the left, and you know the risk of starting up there is that you get forced out to the right, and if you want to go left, you know, that's your risk. But it will be interesting to see.
So here we go. It's the medal race in the NACRA 17, the climax to the NACRA 17 campaign here in Yerres in the World Cup Series in the south of France. 5 seconds to go, and it's all to play for. Five teams hunting for three medals, and they're off right across the line with GBR 299, Ben Saxton and Stephanie Orton getting a good start. But how are the Spanish doing on the far side?
Great start by the Spanish. He just he stayed back a good time before the start, and he just you know, came with a lot more speed into that start and just rolled the whole fleet perfectly timed.
There they are, wearing the yellow bibs of the overall leaders, showing they're on form and showing they're not going to let go of this very easily. Into second place for Vero and Odine of France.
Yeah, they had a very good start as well. They positioned themselves well, got the acceleration right, you know, and made actually sure that the other French boat and the Dane especially had to tack off, and that's a huge gain for them for sure.
So on board with the overall second place boats, Vero and Odine. You need a lot of strength, a lot of top body strength and core strength to sail these boats,
especially from a crew perspective. I mean, the helm in the NACRA is actually a quite easy job. They're very fine tuning. You know, they're just fine tuning that boat and being super concentrated. But the crew is trimming that boat. She's the hand on the pedal of speed, and you know, a perfect trimmer just makes that boat go. And you see Fernando Echevarri and Tara, they've sailed together a long time, and they are the experience in the class right now. And they time that start perfectly, and they sail the boat quite well.
Yeah, the crew really work themselves to the bone. They upwind, they trim the mainsail, downwind, they trim the spinnaker, doing all the work.
Yeah, and they're in a perfect position. You know, they're just following the French, you know, out to the ley line, and taking it pretty easy. You know, they're in a very comfortable position, and they're probably gonna make it a little tough for the French. I think with the French attacks, the Spanish are gonna tack right on top of them.
The fastest boat in the Olympic classes. And if you think they go fast now, in a few months' time they'll be foiling, which will be absolutely tremendous to watch.
Yeah, right now you're seeing they have one hull in the water. In 2 months' time, both hulls are going to be out of the water, and the only thing that's going to be in is actually the foils. And they think the speed is going to increase by 30 to 40%. And, I mean, they're already going fast. It's going to be quite crazy.
The Spanish showing their experience, they're the most established partnership in the fleet. They're always challenging up for the medal places, and they're going to be difficult to overhaul here, although Saxton and Orton are doing their best right now.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised that the Spanish tacked off here. You know, the Danes were sort of following them up to windward, and the Brits, they had the Brits in the window and the French in the window, so I'm surprised they were the first ones to attack, but you know, the Brits, Saxton and Vero has followed now, and right now Echevarri is in a very good spot. It'll be interesting to see crosses coming up here between the Danes and the French, and Saxton out all the way out to the left.
Here we go, an overview so we can get an idea of exactly who is where.
Danes are just crossing, and looks like the Brits are going to duck him as well. But they're tacked behind, so they have to execute this tack absolutely perfect to make sure that they are in a good position. Oh, what are we seeing here? This looks like a penalty.
It's the French.
Yeah, it's a penalty for the French. Oh, that's going to be expensive. That could be the overall silver medal.
Gone, yeah.
And silver medal, I think that takes him down to bronze and probably even potentially closer to not, you know, going out of the tally.
Disaster for Vero and Udine. We'll have a look back to what happened there and let you know, but obviously a penalty for them, and you can see just how much space, how much ground they've lost on the two leaders.
Yeah, I think it was the situation with the with the Danes when they were coming across in starboard. They might have gone and tried to cross and not been able to do that.
It's been good for John Gimson and Anna Burnett on the British boat, though. It's given them a chance to move up to third place and pretty close on the leaders as well.
Yeah, it's all in for the race. Girardi's still got that 30 meter lead that he established in the start, but you know, it's still, you know, 30 meters in these boats. We're talking about a couple of seconds, and there's a long way to go.
And now we see the Italians, who are eighth overall, Tita and Banti, making their way up the fleet. That's another interesting male on the helm, female on the crew. But the leaders right now, all eyes on them. The Spanish, they've already, there's the yellow bibs. They're already in the gold medal position. And that ultimate podium spot is theirs to lose. Teamwork, so important on these boats.
So important. These two have spent so much time in that boat together, sailing since it came into the Olympics 4 years back. They are a strong, strong team, and were actually one of the favorites going into Rio. Didn't have a great Olympics, but you know, they are a strong team, and they've been that for years.
Compared to Saxton and Orton, who are chasing them down meter by meter in second place, who are a brand new partnership, obviously both very experienced indeed, especially Ben Saxton, who's been to Rio in the NACRA, but a new partner for him. So as they come round the top mark, the Spanish launch the spinnaker, off they go, downwind.
Yeah.
Followed closely by the Brits.
Super, super close race here. It's going to be really interesting to see how they're going to pan out.
Some perfect maneuvers there.
Yeah. Bit of a luffing duel here between the Brit and the Italian and the Dane. Nobody wants to be run over, and you will be if you let the other guys get above you. This is close racing. It doesn't get much better than that. It looks like the breeze has picked up just a knot or two, probably looking at 16, 17 knots right now. Absolutely perfect conditions.
On board with the Spanish again. And that gives you a fantastic idea of the fleet behind them, the front of the fleet, with the British sail out at the back, Gimson and Burnett in third place. And then as you go to the left of the screen, you've got fourth and fifth in there as well. 35 meters only separates first and second. It's going to be the Brits are going to try and grind down the Spanish, but that, you know, it's theirs to lose. They've just got to stay calm. They've got to race their race.
It's very close. It's a good opportunity for Saxon. If you can catch up a boat or two, they're actually able to get on the podium with where the French have put themselves after that penalty.
We're talking about just how good these guys are as a partnership. How do you work on that other than being on the boat and putting in hours of racing?
I've heard a lot of people doing personality tests, trying to figure out what triggers performance in people, and if you know what triggers a great performance in the other guy, you try and hit that button as much as possible. So, you know, and they'll do the same towards you, and that will hopefully lift the team as a whole. They work on everything, you know, and that's why, I mean, sailing is a very complex sport. and these guys, actually doesn't matter which class it is, they get up at 7 in the morning and they're working from 7 in the morning to 9 in the evening. This is a full-time job, you know, 7 days a week.
No change in the top three. Steady as she goes. We're looking at Ben Saxton and Steph Orton. Just enjoying that downwind breeze.
There was a bit of a split here between that group of three boats with the Dane, the Italian, and Grimson, and it'll be interesting to see how they come together when they get further down the race course. Looks like the Danes have lost a little bit by jiving off. It'll be interesting to see how it comes. They come to the bottom mark.
Which is happening right now.
Again, nice.
With the Spanish, a nice draw.
Well done by Saxon. I mean, they're actually caught up quite a lot. They're within 10 meters of the leader now. And it's going to be interesting to see how they're going to, how it's going to pan out. I would say Echevarri is probably going a little bit more to the right side of the race course, which is actually the left, but that has shown all day that was the more favorite side, and Saxon and Orton is going out to the right, and it will be interesting to see if there's any changes in that.
Well, I'll tell you what's happened in the overall standings. The French have dropped down a place into the bronze medal position, and the Danes have moved up into silver. And here they are trying to close the gap on Senholt and Lubeck as they round the mark and make their way back upwind.
Yeah, you know, that's one of the few things where I'm going to cheer for the Danes.
Glad to hear it.
Surprise, surprise.
The Danes that never made it to Rio, despite all their best efforts. Lynn Senholt ended up going as a coach of the NACRA team that got there.
They were actually both there because Christian Peter was there crewing in the 49er.
Look, the French are struggling. They seem to have slowed right down at the back of the fleet, Vero and Ordinaire.
Yeah, I mean they were in ninth at the top, and they're still in ninth position. So I mean they have a long way back, but you know there's four or five boats in between them and the Danes, and they have a 3-point lead. So you know if they can just get up and be right behind them, they'll pass the Danes again. But it looks pretty good for the Danes, and they've done smart here. They've tacked, and I'm sure they've tacked to cover for the French.
Well, as things stand in the overall standings, Saxton and Orton just a point now behind Vero and Ordinaire in that bronze medal position. So Saxton and Orton, plenty to sail for. Would they be keeping an eye over their shoulder to see where the French are? Just focused on the front. What's happening in front?
I think Saxton and Orton is just trying to win this race. It's going to be very, very close with the Spanish.
It certainly the lead keeps changing.
Yeah. You know, it's very close. They're going to meet each other in a few seconds' time, and it's going to be interesting to see if the Spanish are going to attack. Yep, here they go. Attacking underneath them, and I'm sure that the lead is going to change again. Gimson's going to be up there, and Saxton is probably going to move up as well. It's, you know, there's a couple of meters in it right now. It's quite interesting. They're attack ahead, but in front of Gimson. So Gimson still needs to do another attack, and as it's looking right now, it's actually. It actually looks like the tack is costing about 50 meters a time.
Yeah, here's a good idea of where they stand. Halfway down leg four, and then it's a short fifth leg to the finish line, a run in for...
It's actually leg three. We're still on leg three. We're still on the upwind. Have a downwind and that last little reach into the finish.
Okay, I think we need to change that in the top corner.
But it's still.
But either way, Saxton and Orton still leading, and your Danes.
Yeah, but look at this, right? You have three boats that are within 15 meters of 10 meters of each other. It couldn't be any closer. This is three boats literally equal. It's super, super, super close. It's going to be very, very interesting to see when they all converge and get together. Gimson is sort of coming across on port, and Saxton and Echevarri is coming on starboard. And they're not on ley line, so Saxton and Echevarri has another two tacks to do, and Gimson can probably only have one. My best guess or advice would be to try and dock the Spanish and the British, and then get out and get that starboard advantage next time around. And I think they'll position themselves well in leading into the next mark. It'll be interesting to see when we meet them right now. Yeah, wasn't that? Or was that another Brit? It'll be interesting. I think there's a good chance that that was them just ducking them right there.
I mean, there's just a few meters between those first three boats. And it just means that these maneuvers have to be spot on in order to hold those positions.
Yeah.
The slightest mistake, or not even a mistake, but just the slightest rough tack.
Yeah, and, just and a bad. Yeah, you know, a bad tack in these boats will cost you 10, 20 meters. And, I mean, look at it. There's a meter or two in it. And the Brits just managed to squeeze ahead of him. But these two boats are neck and neck again, right? So it's just super, super interesting. I think Echevarri here is going for speed and trying to actually get a little bit of distance to Saxton so they can put in the tack and hopefully approach him on starboard and force Saxton to duck him when they have to do the next tack.
Yeah, it's experience against new partnerships. The Spanish know exactly what they're doing, instinctively know what each other does. The others are still learning their way. John Gimson, Anna Burnett have had an up and down week, not an unsuccessful week, but up and down a measure of maybe how they're just still trying to gel, still trying to come together.
You can see here on the lines that Echevarri is going for speed. He's pulling forward, but he's also slipping a little bit in the distance. But he's simply doing that to create leverage between him and Saxton, and actually being able to put in the tack and complete the tack before he meets Saxton. They're going to be trailing. I'm not sure. It's going to be interesting to see when Gimson's doing the tack and whether the Spanish is going to try and cross, or if he's going to duck or tack in front of it. It's going to be very, very close.
It's an absorbing race, this NACRA 17 medal race from Yair. And at the moment, it's no change at the top of the overall standings. But the Spanish, we're on board with them now, holding their lead, holding their overall lead, and looking good, looking very strong
indeed.
Look at
that, he executed that perfectly. He just built that distance, and he squeezed in front of both the Brits. He built the leverage, built the distance, got a little bit of a forward momentum, and then now he's round, and he built that 2-3 boat length advantage.
Round go the Brits. We can see on board with Lynn Senholt and Christian Lubeck.
It's great. Perfect conditions. What a race, huh? With
perfect,
these three
perfect conditions and some perfect sailing, some really perfect maneuvers.
Yeah.
And not giving an inch on the other crews.
No, but you can definitely see the experience came in handy here with Echevarri. He's been in this situation hundreds of times before, and he just played that perfectly. And that's that, you know, has a huge played out to his advantage. Does it look like the French has made a comeback? The Veyron and Audinet, it just looks like they've moved back up to fifth. That's a great second beat. I actually think they managed to get in front of the Danes. Wow, impressive.
I wonder if that was good sailing, or if Senholt and Lubeck, if we've missed a bit of an error on board their boat.
It could be, but it doesn't look like the Danes have moved down. So it actually looks like the French have moved up. They've sailed a very good second beat. It's quite interesting.
They're coming back into form, really, the French. They started second overall, so, you know, they've been in a good position much of the week. But the earlier part of the week seemed to have better results. Yeah. But here they are now. Vero and Ordine leading Senholt and Lubeck. These are the boats that are in silver and bronze medal positions overall.
Yeah, they look to be in a good position here. I think it's going to be tough for the Danes to try and get back from that. It's a great job on that second beat for the French. I think they sort of almost sealed that thing. Only a mistake can mess it up for them now.
And downwind, the Nacra is a really really technical boat.
Yeah, I mean the big issue here is, especially in these waves, is not to stuff the boat into a wave. If you that's the balance, right? You just want to keep that bow out of the waves. If you stuff it, you're going to flip, or you're going to slow down quite extremely. They're doing a really good job, the French here, you know, just balancing that boat out. And we're doing 35 kilometers an hour, there's a lot of force going into these boats right now.
British and Italians looking good. Good balance on that boat.
Definitely good balance. Just looks. You look at these guys and it's, that looks pretty easy, you know? I tell you, it's not. It is really, really, really hard. But they just make it look so easy. And that's the thousands of hours spent on training in these boats. That's a great part of it. They're having a lot of fun, I'll bet you that. It's fantastic conditions.
And in these close races in the Nacra, traditionally, because it's such a fast boat, because moves are quite, penalise you quite a bit. Your tactics tend to, you kind of have an idea before you start what your tactics are going to be. But when it's this close, how manoeuvrable, how flexible should those tactics be?
Well, actually, what we've seen lately is that the manoeuvres in these boats, because they are getting so much better at doing them, when they do them well, they lose very little. Especially on flat water.
As the top three come into this bottom mark, the Spanish still in control. About 50 meters now between them and the chasing pack. And it's hardly anything in it between the two British boats.
Oh, that's close. Perfect race by the Spanish here. Just perfect start. Just played it well. Got a little close with the British for a second, but they just... played the tactical part really, really well at the top mark.
And so Fernando Echavarri and Tara Pacheco make their way towards the finish line. They started the day first overall. They finished the race first and they seal the gold medal in the Nacra 17. A fantastic result from the Spanish. And what a result for Gimson and Burnett and also Saxton and Orton, who come in third place. Saxton and Orton move up from fifth, and Gimson also moving up from further down the fleet. The Italians come in fourth, and then quite a comeback from the French. Vero and Ordine currently sitting in fifth, and they cross the line ahead of the Danes, Senholt and Lubeck. So we know that gold goes to the Spanish as things stand. I think it's silver to the French and bronze to the Danes. Yep. And of course, we'll bring you confirmation of that as soon as it comes through. So a tremendous race, champagne sailing, wonderful pictures, and a wonderful, wonderful experience up on the boats as well. They'll have really loved that race. They'll have enjoyed it. Seat, really edge of the seat stuff from all the top boats and all the top crews, which kind of reflects also on how we started the day with so many crews in the hunt for the three medal places. But in the end, it went to the Spanish. They took gold. They celebrated as they crossed the line, and rightly so. The old partnership is still going strong, and today, experience counted.
It truly did. It truly did. They must be very happy with that result. You know, they've been working hard, and these guys are the experience. You can even see a couple of gray hairs on Fernando. He's been in this game for quite a while in different types of boats, and happy to see him win another big regatta.
A well-earned drink. Time to relax, and you can see the we can see the kites in the background. They're preparing for their medal races, and we'll be bringing you those live in a few moments' time. But what a race from the NACRAs, and what a final result. Confirmation then of the race results, with the Spanish winning the race and winning gold. In second place and in third, it was 2 and 3 for the British. Gimson and Burnett, and Saxton and Orton in second and third, with the Italians coming up the fleet from earlier on in the day up into fourth. The French in front of their home crowd, they started in a silver medal position, but they finished down the fleet. It was enough though to hold on to that silver medal, and the Danes as well did enough to hold on to bronze.